So hey everyone, this is Trevor here. So today's video will be a short one where we will be talking about a simple trick which is coordinate compression, which a skill which is good to have your armory. So before starting, I will request you people to share my channel in your college groups, among your friends, among your juniors, because when I started, I did Codeforces, but then I really took a lot of time to improve. The main reason being I was not able to get the solutions from the editorials. So I'll be trying to post C&D after the contest ends as soon as possible. So it's just a small request. Please share the channel as much as you can in your college and your college mates. So let's understand now what is coordinate compression. So let's take this question where it is said that you are given an array of n integers and you got to count the frequency of every number in the array. That means if you are given this array, so for 1, the frequency is 2. For 2, the frequency is 1. For 1, again, the frequency is 2. For 3, the frequency is 2. For 3, the frequency is 2. So you got to print me this. So how do you do this? So what you do is you take a frequency array, which will be marked like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Till whatever is the maximum constraint, that is, like, let's say if the array integers are from the range 1 to 10 to the power 6, so you will have a frequency array of 1 to 10 to the power 6. So initially everyone should be 0. So you get 1. What you do is go to 1 and mark it as 1. You get 2, you go to 2 and increase it by 1. Next time you get 1, you go to 1 and increase it by 1, so you get this as 2. Next time you go to 3, increase it by 1. Next time you go to 3, you got to increase it by 1 again, and you have completed the array traversal. Now you need the frequency of 1. So we can say the number stored at 1 will be the frequency of 1 because we have incremented it that many times. So we can easily get 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. If I ask you a question, till when can you use this array to count? If your numbers are in the range from 1 to 187, because we know at max we can have sizes of 187 or little bit more than that. But then if the numbers in the array would be of the range something like 10 to the power 17 or 10 to the power 18 or 10 to the power 9. So in that case, so you will say, hey, that's not possible to count in the array because we cannot have that index in the array. So in that case, what you will do is you take a map to count it. So in that case, what you do is you take a map to count your occurrences. But then if I don't want to take map, so how can I do it using arrays? So this is where coordinate compression comes in. So let's understand. So let's say you're given this array. So you got to find the frequency of everyone. So how does coordinate compression work? So what you do is you take this array and sort it. So the sorted form will be 1, 5, 10 to the power 8, so the sorted form looks something like this. Now the next step, what you do is you convert these numbers into 1, then into 2, then into 3. This will stay 3 because the numbers are same. Then this becomes 4. Now since again the numbers are same, you make it 4. Now this is again some new number, so you make it 5. Once you have numbered it, we can say 1 means 1, 5 means 2, 10 to the power 8 means 3, 10 to the power 9 means 4, 10 to the power 10 means 5. Now you come back to the original array and instead of 1, write whatever the value it means. So 1 means 1, 10 to the power 9 means 4, 10 to the power 8 means 3, 5 means 2, 10 to the power 10 means 5, 10 to the power 9 means 4, 10 to the power 8 means 3. So what we did is we compress the coordinates and now we can use the frequency concept which we applied. So you might ask that we are already mapping this, so we are using a map. So you might ask, what is the use of coordinate compression? Because we are already mapping it, like we are mapping 1 to 1, 5 to 2, 10 to the power 8 to 3. So eventually we are using a map, but then this technique can be used in a lot of problems. Now let's say you get a Fenwick tree problem. Over there, you know Fenwick tree only works in ranges from 1 to 10 to the power 7 or 10 to the power 6. Now, if you have numbers like 10 to the power 9, so what you can do is you can perform a coordinate compression and store its corresponding value in the map. And then you can compress the array. And once you have done that, you can use Fenwick tree. Similarly, in the segment tree or similarly to other problems, you can use this concept where you compress your values to lesser values so that you can use a data structure easily. So you might ask that why did you sort it? You could have directly numbered it like one, two, three, four, and then so on without sorting it. But then what that will do is that will rearrange the number. Now, when what do you mean by rearrange? Now, 5 is marked as 4, 10 to the power 9 is marked as 2. So eventually 2 is less than 4, but 10 to the power 9 is not less than 5. So it hampers the order of the array, right? So but if you sort it and then number it, then if 5 is marked as 2, 10 to the power 8 is marked as 2, and 10 to the power 8 is marked as 3. So we can set 2 is less than 3. Similarly, 5 is also less than 10 to the power 8. So let's see how can we implement this in code. So in the code, let's assume B is the array, which is the duplicate array of A, where A is the original array. So we have sorted the B array, and then we have taken the initial index to be 1, and we have also taken a map which stores the mapping of the new number that we are assigning to it. Next step, we traverse in the B array, and then if that element has not been mapped, we map it to some index. Let's say for the first time it comes, so obviously it will not be mapped, so we map it to 1, and then we increase it to 2. So similar thing gets on going. So we know in the map data structure, every number is mapped to a corresponding new number. So once you have done the entire mapping, you come back in the array A, and then change array A by its mapped number. And once you have done that, we can easily say we have compressed the number. Now let's say for some reason you want to get back to the original number, so you need to store that mapping too. So what you can do is you can map that thing in some other map. Let's say you map it in some back. We can easily write here back of index will always be equal to B of I. Now index, that is the new number, was mapped to someone who was B of I. So if we have changed A of I, we know what it will be mapped to, right? Back of A of I will give you the number which previously exists. So guys, this was all about this concept. So I hope you have liked the video. Just in case you have liked the video, press on the like button, do share and do subscribe. Thank you.